Life is like a mountain railroad with an end to near this break. We must make that run successful from that cradle or to the grave. Watch those hills, the curves, the tunnels, never falter, never fade. Just keep your hand upon that throttle and your eyes upon the rain. And bless and say,
unless you have
have more coffee, man. I'll let it go. Yeah. It was 1999. I won the National Elvis Competition. I was the Elvis of all Elvises. And Elvis had some of the greatest gospel music of all time, if you ask me. So we're going to have some fun with this right here.
Why don't you swing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride.
Swing down, chariot, stop it, let me ride. Rock and roll, call it easy, I got hold of the sun. Why don't you swing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride. Swing down, chariot, stop it.
All angels with all the cherry wheels.
What was so particular about the cherry wheels?
Just wanted to see how that cherry would be.
I just remember the cherry stop and let me ride. Swing down, cherry stop and let me ride. Rock me, Lord, rock me, Lord.
Oh, boy, easy. I ain't got a home to me. But I'm the sound of the sweet, sweet, sweet. Well, so you went down and you got on board.
Cherry went among up on down that road.
Zeke went so pathetic, I know crossing the road.
Just want to lay down in the heavy load.
Why don't you swing down, sweet chariot, stop, let me ride.
Beautiful for
See the shining sea. Yes. I thank Linda for inviting us and to come up here to this part of the country. We've never really been to north of East Ohio and to do programs before. And a lot in northwest Ohio, Bryan and Defiance and out through those areas and on down a little bit more south of there. But it's our first time kind of being in this area. And I always heard you people weren't nice, but I found out different. I never heard that, but we're happy again to be here today. I was my grandparents were Baptists. My parents were Assembly of God, and my stepdad sent me to the Catholic school. So Sunday morning I was at the Baptist church. Sunday night and Wednesday night I was at the Assembly of God church. Monday morning, Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, Thursday morning, and Friday morning, I was an altar boy in the Catholic school. So I had a drug problem. I was drugged to church an awful lot. But I thank God that my parents and grandparents took me to church. They taught me about the love of Jesus, and they taught me about the glorification of God. I really do. I'm just so grateful to my family for taking me to church. And we didn't even ask if we were going on Sunday mornings and Sunday nights and Wednesday nights. We knew we were going. Matter of fact, we were shocked if they said, "We're not going to church tonight." We as kids held our hands against their foreheads and said, "Are you all right? Are you sick? Why aren't we going to church?" Because it just wasn't normal. We spent all that time in church. So I like to sing an old gospel song called "I Never Shall Forget the Day When All the Burdens of My Soul Got Rolled Away." And some of you can relate to this one right here. Band, if you don't mind. Long years ago, when I was sick, I had no hope, no peace within. Down on my knees, and I prayed to Jesus, and He gladly set me free. I never shall forget when all the burdens of my soul got rolled away. He makes me happy, glad, free. I sing and shout for He's everything to me. I can feel by my side, my feeble steps, He comes to guide. The trials come, He comforts me. Through faith in Him, we'll say, I have that victory. I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul got sinner, come to Jesus now, at His dear feet, just humbly bow, hopeless to Him. Your every sin, He'll save and cleanse you, give you peace and joy within. And I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul got rolled. For He's everything to me. I never shall
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Thank you.
sing. He said to Rich, you like me. Well, I once was lost, but now, thank you, Jesus, I'm found. I was blind. See now. How many were in darkness at one time, but now they can see? Well, man, I'll tell you what. Oh, so many things that we could just go through and talk about and sing about. And I want to do something. It's on my heart right now to do it. Bobby Bear wrote a song, I believe it was in 1959. Conway and Loretta Lynn used to do that. Bobby Bear and Loretta Lynn first did it, and then later on it was Conway and Loretta Lynn. It's an old country song called God Bless America Again. And you know that song was for sure fitting for that period of time. But Bobby Bear had no clue that in 2015 that song would be more important at this time than it is then. And honey, I'm going to ask you if you'll come over here. She's got such a beautiful voice, and her real name is Angel, and once in a while she is an angel, ladies and gentlemen. And other times I have to remind her that Lucifer was an angel at one time. I know I'm sleeping outdoors tomorrow night. Honey, this is a great song called God Bless America Again. Band, if you don't mind. Times in American history were the 1950s. God, those were the days that men and women didn't lock their cars at night. They left their keys in the ignition. God, those were the days here in America where we, on the hot summer days, we could leave our front doors open so the wind would blow through the screen doors and keep the house cool. We didn't worry about somebody breaking in. God, those were the days where the kids played out way past dark and parents didn't worry about somebody coming along and snatching them up. God, those were the days that the kids prayed in school and said the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, God, I know we had our problems then, but it was just a great time in America. Well, I know, God, we ask you to leave and you're a God of freedom. You'll honor freedom if we tell you to get out of our lives and out of our churches and out of our public places and out of our homes. You'll leave. We know that, God. But we also know, God, that evil will invade. And evil does not recognize freedom. Evil will take over. And God, we've seen evil starting to take over this whole land because we've asked you to leave. And I know, God, you won't bless a place where we've allowed evil to run rampant and allow it to continue to go on. So God, right now, I'm asking that you'll forgive us. And that God, you'll just come back. And that you'll help us to allow you to take back over and make this that great America. That a lot of these folks here today remember the 1950s. So God, I'm asking you to bless America again. Many pastors that are here today, and each one of us can almost recite that 2 Chronicles 7:14 by heart. We've heard it so much lately, that if my people who are called by my name, and let's talk about that just for a second if you don't mind. A lot of folks will say, well, that's Old Testament, that's Israel, that's what he's talking about there. Well, I don't dispute that, but it is in the Old Testament, it is Israel. But you need to understand something. When you say yes to him, you become spiritual Israel. Now you're the people, all right? Now he's talking to us here. My people who are called by my name. The only way you can say yes to him is because he called you first. And then you responded and said yes. So my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek his face. Now that's more than the napkin drop at the dinner table at Cracker Barrel, where you drop the napkin, you go, oh Lord, bless this food right now, and hoping nobody will see you pray. It's a little more than that. It says if they'll humble themselves. Humbling means to say, I'm me and you're God. God, you're the God of all things. And seek his face. And turn from their wicked ways. Now that's the one that starts stepping on some toes. There is so much wicked running around in this world and in our country. It's pathetic. It's wicked. It's evil. And we try to figure out whether we distinguish what's right and what's wrong. Whatever is not pleasing in God's eyes is wicked. From the little things to the big things. Whatever is not pleasing unto him is a wicked thing. Turn from their wicked ways and seek his face.